It was not safe for me to live on my own. It wasn't even a question.
If I didn't come to Rose Hill, I mean, I probably would have been homeless. I was on my way to homelessness. I mean, I was completely mentally sick. I had, you know, no car, no money, no job.
At first, to be honest, I was so depressed and so numb, but I did feel safe.
Part of what I like about Rose Hill, it's not necessarily a medical environment. A lot of people come here, a lot of residents arrive, and they said, you know, I was expecting everyone to be wearing white coats. And none of us wear white coats. There may be one or two nurses or doctors who may wear a white coat.
I was very apprehensive about it because it's kind of like that fish out of water experience. And there was a lot of fear and trepidation with that. But after the first few weeks, I was becoming accustomed to the surroundings and the settings and what I needed to do personally to improve myself over time.
What I've done in the past is just very different from here. It's just different, that's about all I can say. More wards, you know, units, and some group homes.
Rose Hill has something that nobody else has in the community. We have the ability to be with people 24 hours a day. It is a struggle when you're diagnosed with a mental health disorder.
Ryan had done some treatment programs, hospitalization, inpatient and outpatient programs, which were not working for him. They just were not effective. It was constantly reoccurring.
Just a great treatment and rehab facility, the way that they approach it and their caregiving and the idea of having tasks, jobs to do, and the learn at the same time, and therapy of the animal farm, and some of them love being working in the nursery, which she never happened to do. But you know, it's all so therapeutic for them.
What we've learned is that these illnesses are a spectrum. And somebody could be at the low end of the spectrum, the high end of the spectrum, or anywhere in between. And so one of the things we like about what Rose Hill does, all the different pieces of their program, they can fit to anywhere somebody is on that spectrum and then lead them toward the correct recovery for that individual.
When you come to Rose Hill and you are willing to do this program, it is hard work. You're not just living here and going down and working on the farm. You are making changes in your life, and that's hard.
And it was a long process to find a good place for treatment and to heal.
My mental health journey has lasted 16 years. Over the course of that time, I had 14 hospitalizations, wonderful, wonderful professionals. And it wasn't until I came to Rose Hill that it all fell into place, that I really received the whole person care that I need, being outside, getting the fresh air.
When we talk about meeting with Ryan's care team, it's a care team. They know him. I can walk into that office over there and they know us, they know our son, they know specifically where he's at, what's going on, whether it deals with medication, his finances, his work, they know him. And that knowledge has helped them understand when he starts to go sideways, they need to relook at the medication or need to look at the therapy or whatever. They understand. It's not a person understands. This organization understands him.
We understand that there is biological process, medical processes going on. There's psychological factors and there's social factors. And so you have this kind of controlled environment where patients are interacting and may struggle or have difficulties, but there's staff there to help them out, to guide them.
Kind of like a battlefield. So when you've started feeling better and you're surrounded by beauty, by animals, camaraderie as far as groups of people.
At Rose Hill, we have the element of time, that we get to see things over a period of time and make adjustments. If somebody's struggling or having difficulties, we try to do different strategies to help them, whether it be medication, whether it be extra support, or to teach them the coping skills to help them get through stressors, get through family issues.
I was very happy to be here. I just knew that that it was gonna turn around, I guess. My life was gonna turn around. That's how I felt. You know, the hard part is getting to a place like this.
Get up in the morning, look at something that's meaningful and purposeful, and it gives people an opportunity to motivate themselves to do something that they haven't been doing for a long time.
I decided to give the kitchen a try, and I really enjoyed being there. I made the salads every day, and I stepped out of my comfort zone.
I guess my favorite thing about the whole residential program was definitely the farm work.
To be close to the earth and in such a real way and see the magic of growing food.
I just basically soaked it all up and just really just, you know, enjoyed how to catch the donkey when it ran away.
I'm going to get to go and work at the Veterans Cemetery right down the road. And he was so excited about that opportunity.
The staff and residents work together on a daily basis to do things on the same level. I do eat lunch with the residents and other staff.
You, as a parent, you get pretty anxious when you see something that you know potentially could be, you know,
because you've
happen.
Been because you've been living with it.
Yeah.
You know it's
and
there.
And you just say it's going to go sideways and all. And you're just hoping the staff understands. And to my wife's point, not their first rodeo, they understood long before we did, and they were on top of it long before we understood. Again, all those worries and angst that you live with as a family can be set aside and managed through a very competent organization that can help not only your resident, but help your family.
We offer a variety of different group therapies. We also are holistic in the groups that we offer. Some may be therapy groups and processing groups. Others may be Pilates or yoga, which focuses on treatment of our physical self. We also do music, which is also very therapeutic.
An awesome environment to be on 400 acres with beautiful trees and flowers blooming and a lake out back, and you know, and the buildings here, they fit the environment really well. Okay,
it was the right place to nurture and be healed, you know, and I mean this, that happens over a lifetime, but to experience, I really believe in this place, physically, where it is and what it can give people. I really believe in how beautiful the scenery is, and I mean, there are moments that I wish I could just, I wish I could show people the greenhouse, and I wish I could take their hand and walk them down a row of hundreds of roses, and they're all perfect. And or run around with llamas, and there are pictures of me holding a bucket of grain, and I'm surrounded by llamas and my friends laughing, and that's where you get freedom from. All of us have had such heavy burdens walking through this journey.
My life has been really great. I'm really at peace recently. Was recovery over all these past, you know, 2+ years at this point, was it hard? Wasn't always easy, but it's a lot easier than, you know, trying to function, you know, living for your next buzz, or, you know, just crippling anxiety and depression, loneliness, and, you know, pretty much all the problems I used to have are, you know, minimal to non-existent.
So with the help and assistance through the staff at Rose Hill Center, I thank them so much for it too. Yeah, it comes from the heart.
Ryan was always this beaming boy, just happy as could be. With this onset, that smile and that brightness went away. When I saw my son smile again, and the smile came back, that was huge. That was a huge milestone. We got our boy back.
If you're considering admission at Rose Hill, pick up the phone and call us. We're happy to talk to anyone, and we can start to discuss whether we think and you think that it's a good fit to move forward.